Hi, I'm Dan McDonald from MBTI, and welcome to the post-surge Illumos Day. I'm just gonna quick couple of slides to say hello and introduce today. And before every speaker, I'll just butt in really quickly while they're getting the microphone on and their laptop put in. So, how many new to Illumos or new-ish to Illumos people do we have in the audience today? Thank you. Okay, I just wanted to recap Illumos really quickly for new people. So this will be old hat to people, you know, like me or whatever. But Illumos is the open source inheritor of what was OpenSolaris's operating system networking components. Oracle is not involved with Illumos at all. Please do not make that mistake of confluencing the two. Improper confluence has caused so many problems throughout time and space. Just don't make that mistake here. Oracle has nothing to do with Illumos. What comes to mind when you think of Illumos? ZFS and dtrace, Illumos is pretty much the reference implementation for those, although I suspect dtrace has even more goodies inside SmartOS. We'll get to that in a bit. Crossbow, which is network virtualization, and zones, which some people know as containers, and there's been a lot of talk about that lately. It's like, gee, where were you in years ago? But just, you know, preaching to the choir on that one for the most part. Zones can be lightweight Illumos instances. They can be also kernel virtual machine, hardcore VMs. There might be a third kind of zone that's going to get talked about today, but I'm not going to steal anybody's thunder. And people are using all these things to solve problems. Illumos has distributions. The upstream repository, which is called Illumos Gate, contains the kernel, most system libraries, and most system commands. And when people use Illumos, they usually use a distribution. They could use OmniOS. Yes, I put it first because that's what I work on. It's just stripped down, but for traditional servers and traditional server administration. There's Joint SmartOS. They've built their entire cloud on it, and it is great hypervisor focused, and it's got paid support just like OmniOS does if you want it. Open Indiana, if you use the old OpenSolaris Open Indiana, kind of is trying to keep that pushing along. In particular, its hipster version is the one you probably should be using these days, because they continuously keep that one up to date. Nexenta Store, if you want a dedicated storage appliance, he's not here yet, but one of our speakers is from Nexenta today, and he's been doing some great work in file sharing in SIFS in particular there. There's a special database appliance firm called Delphix, and they have a lot of ZFS developers there, and they use Illumos to build their custom-built dedicated database appliance. And there are other distributions too. You may see Dilos floating about, or OpenSXXE for those of you who like your System 5 packaging still. And if you want to contribute, first thing you want to do is start using it. You know, I'm always a fan of eating your own dog food. I run my own server on OmniOS now, and it's working really well. The Illumos repositories are on GitHub. If you want to contribute something, you build it, you test it, you get peer review. We take that pretty seriously. For small stuff, you probably need only one reviewer. For larger stuff, you'll need more than one. And then you submit your change to the Illumos RTI advocates. We don't do traditional GitHub pull requests in Illumos. We have this process. It's kind of an inheritance of Sun's process. And so you submit your change, and an RTI advocate will take a look at it, make sure it looks good, maybe ask you a few questions, and then that advocate will push it into the upstream gate. Distro specific bits, I pick on OmniOS build here, which is our userland build, may have different procedures. So you'll need to check with your distro on that. Today's speakers, we're going to start with Garrett DeMore from AMD, who's the founder of the Illumos project. He's going to talk about some of the work he's been doing deep undercover lately. It should be fun. Next is Robert Mustaki from Joyen, who's going to be talking about his work in further improving network virtualization. Gordon Ross from Nexenta, who's not here yet but will be soon, is going to talk about SMB 2.1 and SMB 3, which I know is in Nexenta Store now, and we hope to upstream that soon. Eric Sproul from ETI, co-worker of mine, will be talking about version deployments with the image packaging system, which is what we use in OmniOS. And we'll be having a talk today with Brian Cantrell from Joyen talking about LX branded zones. It's that third type of zone I was talking about. So, but I have one other thing for OmniOS fans in the audience. Last night we pushed out the new revision of OmniOS release 151.0.12. It's the first one I've actually completely dived into, so that was nice. If you have OmniOS, you're going to want to change your publisher to the 151.0.1.12 repository. And I have release notes and everything all put up on omnios.omniti.com. So, thank you very much for the introduction. Our next speaker is Garrett DeMore. He's at AMD now. He was the founder of the illumos project. He helped me escape Oracle. And when I left Oracle, I went to work at McCenta for a few years. And he's going to be talking about making illumos a little more POSIX happy and maybe getting around some of the historical weirdness inside illumos. Garrett, here you go.